Okay, welcome everyone to RefineM's June. Wow, it's already June. June webinar, and we are going to talk about new ways of working for remote agile teams. So as I do my coaching and consulting work, I see a lot of teams are working remote. Almost every team is working remote, agile or non-agile. It actually poses more challenge for agile teams since they have to work very closely, interactively, and a lot of things happen in agile teams every minute, every hour. So there's a lot of interaction that goes on for agile teams, and it becomes really, really challenging. And teams and organizations, individuals have found different ways of working together still, even being remote. So I want to have this conversation here today with all of you, and you may have your own experiences too. I'll share my experiences, and all of you have your experiences too. So let's see if we can come out with something that all of us can benefit with. So this is the agenda. We are going to talk about what has changed and what kind of challenges remote agile team face. What are the strategies? What do we do and how do we solve this problem? And what are the tools? I think tools are now playing a very significant roles, very significant. Though, you know, when the teamwork, agile team works, you know, people and interactions are more valuable than tools and processes. But in today's context, I think tools are playing a very significant role, very, very significant role. So I don't know if somebody is going to change the manifesto, but this period when, you know, is important. Tools have become very, very important. Okay. What are your expectations from this webinar? We are going to use Menti. And let's see if I can bring up Menti here. There was somewhere here, Menti. Yeah. So if you can go to Menti, the code is 7770-1142. If you go there and if you can interact with me through Menti. So menti.com and 7770-1142. What are your expectations from this webinar today? Learning, okay, very good. Anybody else? Ideas for remote teams, collaboration, unique ideas on how to work with remote teams. Excellent, excellent. Any more thought, others' experiences? Yeah, I think that's get a feel of what struggles, something new on agile effectiveness, agile team with members in US and India. I think that's pretty common when team members are at two different locations. You're better in working on agile remote team tools. Okay. Very good. Excellent. Let's move on. Some of you who don't know me, for them, I have been working as a project manager, agile coach for several years. In December 2011, I started my own company, RefineM. And this webinar comes to you through RefineM platform. I also do webinars through projectmanagement.com once in a quarter. And through RefineM, I do agile coaching, consulting work, project management consulting too. I have also developed tools or products that some of those you see here, and some I'm going to show you in a couple of minutes. Before starting my own company, 20-25 years, I did project management, mainly project management. Everything you, which almost you can imagine, everything in project management. So that has been my career. And this is what is we are doing at RefineM. The free webinars come to you every first Wednesday of the month. And the next one, we are going to talk about making your dreams come true, strategies to get your dream job. This is something that I have been doing. I have been doing career coaching, group level, individual level, and I will share some of those learnings from there in this webinar. So if you want to, if you have a dream and you want that dream to come true, just join this conversation on July 7th. We have PMP exam prep classes continuously going. We have products and self-paced training. We are running 50% off right now. So if you go to those pages, you will get to see that information. We are also authorized training provider of PMI that we got last year. We are going to continue with that partnership with PMI for this year and several years to come. We offer several trainings, and you can find our trainings on our training page. And we also offer affiliate program where you can promote our products and services. Your customers will get discounts, and you will also earn commissions on when you promote our program. So if you are interested, you can contact us at trainings@refineem.com to get started. We have partnered with a tool company called as Kanbanize, It's one of the two tools which are recommended by Kanban University as a true Kanban tool. If you are interested in learning about the tool, you can sign up a 30-day free trial with full support from us. Here is the code that is at the bottom of this page. If you signed up through our regular process, you will get a copy of this slide deck, and you can have this URL there, and you can sign up for free, try it out. If you like it, then let me know, and we can arrange this for you. So let's go to another question here. What challenges do you face with your remote agile teams? Let's go back to Menti here, and let's talk about the challenges. What challenges do you face with your remote agile teams? The same Menti, same code. You don't have to log in again if you are still there. Yeah, participation, interaction, accountability, engagement. Yeah, that is something like I think that is what is the key thing. The smaller team, okay? I don't know what the challenge is, smaller team. Engagement, accountability. Wow, okay. Interaction, engagement, I think the same thing, engagement or interaction. So that's what seems like the engagement comes out here very clearly, that engagement is a big challenge. Of course, availability, absence of co-location, multiple location, missing interactions, engagement, that is participation. So mostly related to how do you engage with the team. That's the biggest challenge. I completely agree with this outcome that I see here on this Menti. Okay, let's go back. So let's talk about what changed in recent time. All of us, or most of us, have idea about it, but let's see what changed in the recent time. So pandemic. I think that's a huge thing that's all over the globe, right? It's all over the globe. It caused uncertainty and delays in 2020 that still have impact in 2021. Many teams had to become remote. we know that it was not their choice. Some of the teams, you know, I know some of the team or team members never knew how to even use Zoom. It was like that, but they were forced to. They were forced to because they cannot go to the workplace. They were forced to. They had to become remote. And it massively abrupt, there was a massively abrupt shift in ways of working. Different ways of working, like earlier, you go to office, reach office, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, whatever time you reach. You are there in the office up to 5 or 6 o'clock in the evening, whatever your time schedule, you work for most of the time, have breaks, meet people, go with lunch with people, have some fun, have some conversations, socialization. But that all changed, right? We all know that all changed, and many teams are still figuring out how to effectively work remotely. Many teams are still figuring it out. And also business environment changes happened. So businesses are creating more remote teams to enable development round the clock. We are talking about, you know, the teams, or I think somebody expressed here, how do we coordinate between the teams in US and India? And there is an advantage of round the clock. I have worked with many such teams on both sides. I worked in the teams when I was in India, and also when I came here, then I worked with those teams in India, worked with the teams over here. So it's actually, businesses can use this as their advantage. So the teams here can finish their day and, you know, the work for the team in India is ready, or the other part of the globe is ready, and they finish their part and send the work here. So it's like working round the clock. And if you can manage to do that, I think that's a very wonderful thing, very productive way of working. And the downtime is reduced, which enables faster time to market, because now you're working, probably 160, 70, 80%, faster. And also businesses can save on real estate costs. And we all know that, you know, the real estate costs are going down when a commercial real estate, maybe personal real estate costs are still going up, but the commercial real estate costs are going down, and it is expected, or it is seen, that there is a saving of 5,000 to 8,000 per employee. So when somebody works from home, that is what companies can save. So that's a big number when you add, you know, number of people, 100,000, 10,000, 50,000, 60,000, 100,000 people. When you add that number, that's a pretty significant saving that you can get by, adding virtual teams or having people work from homes. So that's a lot of, plus side of for the businesses too. So what are the challenges that agile teams face? So we saw what changed abruptly. What are the plus side of working remotely? And now let's get into the challenges that the remote teams face. So let's talk what is lost by going remote. What was there earlier, and that is not there anymore, right? So frequent in-person contact. That used to happen, like I will be sitting in my seat and I may just want to go to the restroom or go for a cup of coffee or something, and I can talk to somebody. Or even for the work purposes, I can go to somebody to their seat and talk. There's a lot of in-person contact that is lost. Hallway conversations, when going across, hey, how are you doing? So those kind of hallway conversations, and you know, those are kind of motivating. You may be sitting at your desk and for hours, and then you're struggling. Sometimes you face challenges in what we are doing. You're trying to solve a problem and you're hitting against a wall, and maybe you stand up and walk out, meet somebody, had a 5-minute conversation, and they might give you some ideas. So those hallway conversations are really, really very, very good. On the fly whiteboard sessions, and you take your one of the your colleague and say, hey, let's go to the whiteboard, let's do this, let's figure things out, or discuss a problem, come up with solutions. Access to agile workspaces. Before pandemic, many teams and many organizations have started creating agile spaces. I consulted a couple of organizations to create agile workspaces. And if you don't know what agile workspaces, it is in different forms and shapes. The most common ones are like the team of 8, 10, 12 people. Agile teams are normally small teams. So 8, 10, 12 people. And instead of having cubicles, there may be a table in the middle of the room, a big room. In the middle of the room, you have a table and everybody comes and sits on those that table with their laptops, and they can talk. And the wall space is used as a whiteboard. And you can get up anytime, have a conversation there on the whiteboard. So everybody can see that, everybody can learn from that, everybody can ask questions. So more and more engagement, more and more collaboration. And many agile workspaces also have personal spaces for the team members across the wall. So you may have a little desk there, maybe a little shelf or drawer or whatever you want to keep your personal things. You have that space too. And many other organizations have created different kind of agile workspaces. So by going remote, you miss that, right? Easy access to decision makers. You want to go and have a quick talk with your manager, with your supervisor, and many supervisors in agile teams or agile companies allow you to, open door policy kind of thing. You can go, and if they are not busy with meeting or talking to somebody, you can talk to them. Going out for lunch, socialization, on the fly. You met somebody in hallway, it's at lunchtime. Hey, would you like to join me for lunch? Oh, yeah, okay, let's go there, wherever. And lot of several other collaboration opportunities. So maybe you have some ideas which you can see, okay, this is what we lost. And and you can actually share that in the chat box, if you would like to share in the chat box, so you can have your conversation with other folks as we go through this presentation. Okay, so that is what we thought was lost by going remote. So dealing with a sudden shift that happened last year, pandemic came us practically overnight, right? It was so quick. Many of the agile teams were not ready. There was no time to do any kind of planning. Businesses started closing. Everybody went remote. There was a whole lot of confusion. I remember March, April timeframe last year. It was kind of a chaos, and because things, the situation was getting worse every day, kind of thing, and nobody knew what's going on. So that created a lot of uncertainty, a lot of confusion. And adjustment time was greater for teams not used to remote work. So teams that were not doing any kind of remote work, they were all co-located and they used to go to their agile spaces or their organizations, and that adjustment for them was greatest or greater than the other teams that were partially working remotely. So for those team, adjustment was quick. I coached many teams that were already remote. So if the teams were remote, or at least remote, not in the sense that everybody's working from home, but maybe, the team was divided into two or three locations, and each location will have team members that were co-located in that location, but maybe the team was spread over in two or three locations. That was pretty common. But everybody working from their homes was not so common. And there was a very sudden shift that happened. And the good news out of this is that, first of all, when you are a part of agile team, you welcome change, right? You welcome change. Even it could be disruptive or sudden. So with the agile mindset, you always welcome change, right? You always welcome change. You create plans, but you welcome change. So you have that mindset, the changes can come. So if you have actually transformed to agile culture, then you can handle change in a much better way, in a much better way, even if it is a very big change, even if it came all of a sudden, right? You know how to deal with that. You have that mindset that you can deal with that. So agile teams, were and are more prepared to deal with the change as compared to non-agile teams. So that's a kind of a good news that the teams, agile teams are already well prepared. And being remote doesn't mean losing productivity. You know, in fact, there are research and studies. One of them, you can see the reference down below, the productivity actually increased from 10 to 43%. So with the, team members being virtual, and the downside was that you cannot go out anywhere, right? You have to be at home. So what you will do? You ended up working, right? And all of the agile teams, people who work on teams, they like working, right? So earlier you were spending time in community, commuting to office back and forth, in between time loss. And we used to say, okay, on an average, you can say about 30 hours per week is the effective productive time, because you need time to go for lunch, you have breaks, you have email, checking of emails and all those kind of things. But when you are sitting at home, you don't take that time out for all those kind of things. Normally, you may start working at 8 o'clock in the morning or so. You keep, you have your breakfast, you have your lunch and everything. Some of that can happen on the table, right? And then while you're working, you cannot go out for lunch and spend an hour with somebody, because where you will go, right? And then you can keep working through evening, like 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and you keep working. So that is what was seen. And in fact, some of the studies have started coming that most of the organizations were a little bit more profitable during this time, because the employee productivity went up. So that's a good side of the situation. So before we go there, I want to open up this for a little conversation. So what kind of other pluses or good things you have seen? We have talked about, a lot of negative things about it, but let's talk about what are the good things. Has anybody seen it? You can open up your microphone and talk, or you can put it in the chat. Let's have a 2-minute conversation here. What are the good things you have seen? Anybody want to share? You can open your microphone and talk. Anyone? Good things that you have seen. Are you able to open your mic? Okay. Something coming in the chat here.
Yeah, I was going to say improved of relations with our family members.
That is
being at home.
Yeah. And I see here productivity, more personal time due to lack of commute, more focused time. Diane is talking about more focused time. Increased productivity, greater accessibility. Kristen is talking about greater accessibility. Yep, that is right. That is right. Colleagues are comfortable to deal with technology. Yeah. Yeah, Bala is talking definitely some of the boomers in financial industry. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Better off environment due to fewer cars on the road. Yeah, that is true. Yeah, many places I know that the pollution level went down. Greater proficiency in collaborative. Yes, yes. Yeah, Chris, that's true that many people didn't know how to use Zoom. And now, you know, everybody in home knows how to use Zoom. People are doing Zoom meetings and Zoom parties and, you know, Zoom, what they call is movie watching together and all that. So it has also become fun thing. So there are a lot of positives also of the situation. So I'm glad that some of you, many of you observed that. So that's wonderful. Okay, so what are the new ways of working for remote teams? So let's talk about the new ways of working for remote team, and then we'll have a conversation about the tools also. So new ways of working and the tools that the teams can use. I think those two are important things to take away from this webinar. So the very first thing, I think what needs to happen since the situation is new, everybody's remote, so how do we work together? So very first thing comes is having some working agreements. You know, in agile teams, teams are very familiar with what they call as social contracts. You know, how we are going to work. What are the rules of engagement? And if your team has developed a working agreement before pandemic, those working agreements may not be valid. You have to go back and look at those working agreements, you know, team charter or social contract, whatever you want to call, some way for everybody in the team to come together and say, this is our new social contract. If you have not done it, this is the number one thing you should be doing. Get together with the team and talk about how to address time zone differences. Right, if you are working like for the same team, the team members could be anywhere, you know, within US even, you know, from East Coast to West Coast, 3-4 hours difference. I just delivered training a couple of weeks ago, and it was 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern time, and the facilitator or the technical you know, facilitator to make sure the Zoom and the infrastructure works. She was from San Francisco, and the training started at 8. I was supposed to be there at 7:15. She was there at 4:15. So we need to be aware of those things, even within the area, within Europe, within US, or if it is across, then again, you know, you need to be more. More aware of where the team members are. I have seen some team members having a kind of a little map and say, okay, our team members are here, right? So that will be good to know. Okay, so how do we address team time zone differences? Well, when should be our, you know, ceremonies like stand-ups, grooming calls, planning, prioritization, reviews, demos, retrospectives, whatever teams do. Now we need to figure out how do we take care of time zone differences. And then we decide general availability and meeting time. So other than meeting time, what is the general availability when everybody is going to be available? Because of time differences, the times can change, like 8 a.m. Eastern, will be 5 a.m. You know, Pacific. You can't expect the person to be there at 5 a.m. But maybe they are there at 7 a.m. or something like that. Or so you decide, you know, everybody will be in the office or be available between 8 a.m., between 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Central Time or something like that. That actually maybe 6 hours, 5 hours, let the team decide. The how much availability, 4 hours in a day, 5 hours in a day, 6 hours in a day, and what is that time? what is that time? Use of video and other tools for the remote collaboration, how we are going to use video. Do we want everybody to be on video from all day or during that general availability time? What remote tools we are going to use? So I think some of the agreements around that we are going to use there, and there are multiple tools, and I'm going to talk about those tools. So for what purpose we are going to use which tool? I think that's again is a kind of working agreement that we all agree. Team's priorities, where team is going to focus, what are their priorities? Cultural differences, if they are across the globe, those were there too, but now it may be more because people are now working from homes. And any other thing that you think is required for thing to be considered in charter, what do you think are the things that other than this should be there in the charter or the team working agreements? Any other thing other than that, you can use chat box or you can talk. So any options, anything that you can think of. So I talked about time zone differences, general availability, meeting times, use of videos, use of tools, team priorities, respecting culture, respecting country-specific holidays. Yeah, Cindy, very good thought. Yeah, country-specific holidays. That's true. And basically, maybe team gets all the holidays from all over the world, right? That's not a bad thing. Team is already 10 to 43% productive. Conflict resolution approaches. Yes, Chris, I think how do we approach this in a remote environment? This is different, than face-to-face. If you have a conflict, it is easier to resolve when you are face-to-face. But if you are not face-to-face, it's a little bit more challenging. Out of office expectations. Yes, Scott. Yeah. When not to expect a response. Very good. Very good. Yeah. Different weekend for different countries, especially Middle East. Yeah, Mustafa, you're right, because there are different weekends. So maybe you have to come to an agreement on what are going to be your off days. So I think there are a lot of things on the table. And I will say this is the first thing. If you have not done this with your teams, if you have not done it, hopefully you have already done it. But if you have not done it with your teams, this is the first thing. Develop working agreement. And it doesn't take a lot of time. It doesn't take a lot of time. Probably maybe an hour long conversation, maybe a follow-up 30-minute conversation from there. It doesn't take a lot of time. But include the whole team, the scrum masters, the first line managers, whosoever is responsible for facilitating this with the team. Include all team members in that. And maybe also it will be great if you include your customers and stakeholders, because they are also part of your team, right? They are also part of your team. So include product owners, customers, stakeholders also in this conversation, and take their things into account. Now, what other things you decide where teams are going to work? Are they going to be fully remote post-pandemic? Now we are thinking some of the countries are kind of post-pandemic, like United States and Europe and all that, but some were, India and maybe a couple of other places, they are still within the pandemic. So how do you do this? Is it going to be fully remote? Some companies have announced that they are going to be fully remote. Most teams, my thought is, will have somewhat hybrid way of working, some off on some work from home. Some team members may want to flex to work from home and office as needed. So do we allow that? Is your company allowing? Is the team allowing? So these are the considerations. And co-working spaces or office rentals may be something that can help with flexibility, right? If everybody doesn't want to come together in the office, then particularly for smaller companies, co-working spaces are a very good idea. And for larger companies, if they want to do some office rentals and want to give up all the building space and have only limited building space, That could be some of the things that they, so it is basically the organization, teams, team members, everybody need to be talking about it. How the things look, you know, post-pandemic, or how, where the teams are going to be working. And then based on that, several other things will work out. And I see that, you know, some of my clients have started doing like 50% on site and 50% working from home. And slowly they are moving towards, you know, 100% on site. But some may say, no, we are not going to be 100% on site ever. So whatever is the company policy, whatever is how our team wants to work. But this is another thing that need to be talked about. What is our new way of working, where teams are going to work, how they are going to work, what are the situation that we think the team need, or what are the facilities or support that team needs in terms of working spaces. That is one of the consideration, one of the things that need to be thought through and decided. The other is how do teams connect better in a full virtual or in a semi-virtual environment? What are the things that can be done to keep the team connected? As we see that, you know, number one challenge we all saw was the engagement. How do we improve this engagement? So think of activities, you know, that can make teams feel included, like online happy hours. Many, many teams are doing it. Some teams do once a month, some teams do once a week. So whatever works out for your team, happy hours, game nights, people play games together. The teams play during maybe happy hours or during game nights, and many others. The socialization aspect, like earlier, like a team lunches. So you cannot do team lunches. You cannot go to the restaurant. Maybe after some time we may be able to go, but may not be right away. So you can do some of like you know, online. Many companies will say, okay, here is the everybody can order. Here is your coupon or whatever, and you can go order, and then everybody's on a video, we eat and chat and all those kind of things, as if we are sitting together. Virtual water cooler huddles that Mohammed has put in the chat box. Increased video time. I think that's another important thing, increased video time. And video makes, you know, is little closer to face-to-face. So I should be, you know, should have flexibility to for doing unscheduled video calls. Like if I'm going to your seat or your cubicle or your room and can say, hey, I want to talk to you. So that could be unscheduled video call, one-on-one or group video call. You can, you know, on the fly, like, you know, we can pick two or three people and go on a whiteboard and do a session. Hey, we want to have a conversation about it. So you can have a unscheduled video calls. So whatever way you can have the team connect better. So think about how do you connect. And these all things that we are talking about, you can make it a part of social contract or working agreements. So that's so powerful. The concept of working agreement or social contract has become so powerful that you can discuss all these different aspects and take it back to that, and so that everybody is on the same page. So if I call you an unscheduled call, video call, I'm using WebEx or Zoom or whatever video calling tool I'm using, you know, there is a feature in most of the thing that I can call you directly. So I can do a video call and you should not feel offended with that. So that need to be agreed upon in advance, that during this general availability time, anybody call anyone on video unscheduled, you know. So everybody knows what is expected and this is expected. So they don't feel bad about it. Like you don't feel bad about if somebody walking to you in the office and say, hey, can you come, let's have this conversation, and you don't mind it, right? So similar way, doing it an unscheduled video calls, will be very helpful doing some of that. And then I think there is how else teams can be supported, because team members are tired, exhausted, right? They are working a lot, and there is no social venue kind of a thing, you know, just sitting at home. And the tiredness can be physical, mental, or emotional, or all of three, right? So what you can do, you can start some wellness programs. You can, as a company or as a team lead or a manager, you can think about what kind of wellness programs you can offer to your team members that can be delivered remotely. There are a lot many that can happen. Extend mental health outreach and support to the team member. Find ways to let team member express themselves, what they are feeling. So provide some safe spaces where they can come and talk to the manager or their supervisor, and should be able to express it openly. And arrange some webinars, pep talks, right? How to stay emotionally healthy. What they have to do. So doing some, like, you know, lunch and learn like this in your companies and talking around such topics. I think that will be very, 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 very useful. Doing some pep talks, you know, helping them to boost the morale and increase the motivation. That will be very helpful. Once in a while, once in a month, if you have pep talks, if you have webinars on topics not related to their work, but more related to how do you stay physically and emotionally healthy, right? That will be very good. That will be excellent. And I think everybody would like those kind of things. So those are some of the things to consider when you talk about determine what are the new ways of working. And before we go to tools, does anybody has any other things that you need to consider in your new ways of working that I have not covered here? Anything that you think we should be considering other than what I mentioned here? Yeah, I think you may be thinking, some of you may be thinking, you can talk or write. Okay, yeah, different needs based on gender and religion. Yes. Yeah, I think that is right, Jill. That is right. Different need based on gender and religion. Absolutely. Absolutely. There's a whole lot to think about. Whole lot to think about, right? So it's not easy, but at the same time, I think it's doable. It's very much doable if you just consider children being at home, and don't shy away from that. You know, children, pets, older people being at home, you know, that's how the home is. You know, you have other people at home, right? You have other people at home. And if you're working every day from home, they may come near you, and that's all right. And I think that is what should be acceptable. That's all right. Don't forget, yeah, pets, virtual learning, online business resource group, Cindy. Yeah, okay, very good. With common interest, discuss support for each other, online business resource groups. Very good. I think that's a good resource if other wants to tap into that, what Cindy is sharing here in the chat box. Excellent, excellent, very good. So now let's, for next 5-10 minutes, let's talk about tools for remote agile teams. And as I was telling you, tools have become significant part of new ways of working, a very significant part of new ways of working. So let's talk about what are those tools and what they do. So first is the video conferencing. You have to have a video conferencing tool. There is no way that you can do work in remote team without a video conferencing. So that allowed for big, small, highly interactive meeting, breakout rooms. I think that is a plus thing if your tool has a breakout room kind of a. I deliver trainings all the times, and you know, earlier days, if the trainings, you're 25, 30 people sitting, you divide them into smaller group. They sit across, you know, each table and have the conversation or exercises. So that can be simulated if you have breakout rooms. And that works really very, very well. It really works very, very well. I have used breakout rooms with Zoom, and it has worked really well. So you can have Zoom, WebEx, Microsoft Teams, GoToMeeting. There are several of those. And you need to have one video conferencing tool. Decide which one you want to have, and then have that tool. And then file sharing, or you know, the information sharing or file sharing. So keep documents in one place for ease of access, or one source of truth. You know, version control, make sure it has version control. So anything you can use SharePoint by Office 365, Dropbox, Google Docs, Citrix file sharing, whatever you want to use, you can use that. You need one tool to do file sharing, one tool to do video conference, one tool to do file sharing. That is important. And then you need to have a tool for visualization or doing a whiteboard kind of a thing. You know, as I was talking about that, you can have a unscheduled video call and have a whiteboard kind of a conversation. So it's kind of digital workspace. So you can use Miro or any similar tool. I use Mural a lot. So Mural or Miro, and maybe there are others which are possible. You can do votings. You can do the business process mapping or value stream mapping. You can do even retrospectives, and there are templates that are provided by both Mural and Miro to do retrospective. You can do planning together, anything that you can use for whiteboard, sticky notes, and those kind of collaborative way, like everybody having their sticky and go stick it, for planning or retrospective or for value stream mapping or whatever you do to bring the team together and have a common understanding and have a conversation around those sticky notes. So this is very helpful, very powerful visualization or a whiteboarding tool that you need, that you will need. So Mural and Miro are the kind of two my favorite ones. You can pick any of those tools. So this is the third kind of tool you will need: video conferencing, file sharing, and visualization. And then visualization of work, how the work is being done. So you'll need some Kanban tool for that. Kanban tool, and Kanbanize is the one that I have started using. It's a very powerful tool, as I was talking about, but you can use, Trello is a startup tool. You can start with that, but then it doesn't go too far. Many organizations have Jira. So use Jira, that's perfectly fine. So you can have your work. For example, this is our sales pipeline that we have here, and we use Kanbanize for that. And you can have swim lanes, divide upon type of work or the person who is doing it or whatever way. And then what are the different work states that your work goes through? And you can establish it through a value stream map and then convert that into a tool. So you visualize your whiteboarding thing, and then you visualize the work, and pick up any Kanban tool that will be very, very, very useful. Okay. And then some surveys, quizzes, fun things. Mentimeter, I was showing you the Mentimeter. That's for fun thing, online polling, surveys. If you want to do some quizzes, we are going to do a quiz soon, okay? So if you want to do quizzes and collect some quick, on-the-fly feedback, very good tool to collect those kind of on-the-fly feedback. So that's another tool that is going to be very, very useful for teams to work together. Like if you want to do story point estimation, could be a good tool. People can pick up 1, 3, 4, 5, whatever they have. You can set up your polling for that. You can use sticky notes on the Mural too, right? You can use this too. So whatever works out for you, that will be good. Any other area where you think we need to have a tool. Any other area, I talked about maybe four or five different areas or type of work that you do or areas where you need tool. And you can type in the chat box, and I'm moving to the next question on the mentee. So out of what we all discussed concept today, what do you think is most beneficial for you and your team? Whatever we talked today in last 30 minutes or so, what do you think is most beneficial for you? Adaptability, tools, yeah. Yeah, very good. Anybody else? Adaptability tools, communication tools, yeah. Setting expectations, yeah. Having that, you know, the social contract, that is very helpful in setting a team charter. Yeah, that's what I was talking about, team charter. That is right. Social contract, yeah. Chris has mentioned and that's so. If I were to say two things, social contract and tools. So what are the things, how we are going to work, where the teams will be located, you know, or what tools the teams are going to use. So I think if you just focus on those two and try to capture this, you know, in a more simple way. So what is your social contract and what are your tools? That captures almost everything. What is your ways of working? That should capture everything. That I think just to simplify it, just two things, team charter and tools, decision about tools and the team charter. So if you do these two things, I think you will be able to set up your teams for remote or partial remote or hybrid remote or whatever you want to call that kind of work. Okay, so we'll go to quiz now. Let's see about the quiz. Okay, and so winner will get free access to agility assessment tool. You are all agile teams. And if you want to know how your teams are doing in terms of agility, how mature they are, this tool will be very useful. And you can keep using tool as you make improvements and see how the agility improves. Okay. All right. So let's go to the mentee and have this going. So players are joining. So there's going to be five questions, and you have to respond right and respond quickly. Okay, respond right and respond quickly. Okay, so here we go. So first question comes up. Which of the following is a way that teams can use Mural? Okay, so hold retrospectives. That's the right answer. Let's see how the scoring looks like. Okay, seems like Chris is leading it. Very good, Chris. Let's move forward. The next question coming up here. Oops. Question 2 of 5, let's say. Sorry about that. Okay, many of you are right. Let's see how the scores look like. Okay, seems like Chris is keeping his lead. Yeah, this should be simple. Which of the following tools used to visualize work. Okay, most of you got it right. Wow, some people have come up. Kristen, let's see if there any change. Oh, wow, Kristen gone up. Okay, Kristen. We talked about this. There was a study that I showed you. No, I didn't show you the study. I shared you the link for the study. Yeah, most of you got it right. Okay, Kristen is leading. And I guess this is the last one. Let's see if there is an upset. Okay, most of you got it right. And let's see who wins. Oh, wow. Look at this. Okay, Santosh Kulkarni. Santosh, please email me the screenshot so I know your email address. And here is my email address. I'm putting it here in the chat. And I will send you the access to the tool. Well done, Santosh. Well done. Very good. Very good. Excellent. He just came behind, right? Okay. Very good. All right. So what conclusion remote agile team has to adjust? Both gradual and abrupt changes, more communication and deliberate strategies will help. And tools can be a big help. So that's what we learned today. Next, lunch and learn, making your dream come true strategy to get your dream job is going to happen on July 7th. And register now to join that conversation. Our next PMP course starts on October 14. We are running a 25% off till 6:15. So if you or anybody interested in PMP class, and if you are interested in design thinking, we are going to do a one-day class on design thinking on August 26. And this that also has a 25% off if you register before 6:15. So go ahead and register. We are going to have this class on August 26. This is how you are going to earn one PDU. The claim code that you see here will be active for until end of June. After end of June, this claim code will not be active. We'll have the claim code for July. So if you want to go and get your one PDU for this, you can take this claim code before the end of June. And after end of June, this goes away. Any questions? We are right there a couple of minutes. So I will open up the microphones. So any questions, and I will stop sharing. So anybody would like to ask a question? Or you can ask a question in the chat box, or ask a question, open up your microphone and ask a question.
No questions, but just a thank you, NK. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Chris. Thank you.
Thank you, Azza.
Okay.
Same here, NK. Thank you. Very informative session.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, all right. Thank you very much for joining. I'll see you on 7th July. Okay, 7th July for my next webinar. Thank you. Thank you very much.